guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to DLuna DIY Mom. My name is Denise. Good morning, everybody. Good morning to me because it's morning right now when I'm making this video. And I went to get my coffee so I can have energy because I'm out of coffee and I need to go to Costco to get more. So anyways, this is part two of the previous video that I did for DIYing my kids' canvas paintings with Disney characters. My son was Monsters, Inc. And for my daughter, right now for this video that you're gonna watch, I'm gonna make four Disney princesses. So these are the most simplest ones that I found online and I'm trying to replicate them. To avoid making my introduction so long, please don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to my channel so I can make more videos and let's get to it, guys. Oh, Candy's right here. Say hi, Candy. Say hi. She always wants to be here when I'm here. That's her little spot. So anyways, let's get started, guys.
Believe it or not, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Now Santa. Could be bad.
So I started with the Cinderella one, guys. So first I used a spatula, but then I noticed, oh no, that's not the kind of finish that I want on this background. So I used my sponge brush that I got from the Dollar Tree. And I grabbed some darker, like navy blue acrylic paint on the top part, then the middle part, a lighter blue, and then the last part, a really light blue. So that's what I did for my background, guys. Now I went online and I printed out my picture and I cut it out. I used my X-Acto knife to cut out the precise parts and then I traced it onto my canvas once my background was dry. Then I used a small thin brush and I grabbed my black acrylic paint and then I painted inside and I traced the Cinderella silhouette. So for this painting, I did start with the background, not like the Monsters, Inc. paintings where I traced and then I was just painting bits by bits. For this one and also the Little Mermaid, I'm going to be using this technique where I'm going to do the background first and then paint the black silhouette in the front. So once my black painting is dry here, then I'm going to use a fan-like brush to paint the little magic around her dress in white. So I started doing it when the paint wasn't dry and it was going gray. So then I waited. Now that it's dry, now I can paint with the white and then you have it. That's it. Let's go to the next one. Now for this Tangled one, I didn't trace. I just looked at the picture, my inspiration picture, and I winged it. I just made the lines where I wanted the paint to be. Then again, I painted the navy blue on the top of the sky. Then the middle blue is like a little bit lighter than this navy blue. And then the last blue is the lightest blue. And I am using like a dab method because on the inspiration picture it looks like it was the dab method where it's kind of like pixelated. So that's what I did, and after this is all just straightforward. I'm just gonna let you watch, guys. Thank you. For The Little Mermaid, I did do the background first again, and I dropped some paint on the canvas, and I'm using my spatula, guys, because that's just how the inspiration picture looks like, that the canvas was painted, the background was painted with the spatula to get that effect. So the chunkier you put the paint, like a lot of paint, and then you just scoop it up with the spatula, you kind of use the spatula like if you were icing a cake. That's just how I think about it whenever I'm icing a cake. And I noticed, like, for example, this white, the white acrylic paint, it was a little bit more chunkier and more dense. So it plastered onto the, or I don't know what the exact word to describe it is, but it went onto the canvas, like, really nicely, like the effect that I wanted, to be honest, rather than the blues where it was more liquidy. So I don't know, like, where I can get some painting acrylic paints like that, or if anybody knows of some brands of acrylic paint that come out just like the, like a little bit chunkier and dense like the white one I have. So comment down below if you have some suggestions. So yeah, I'm always up for suggestions and new painting techniques. I'm not an expert at painting, but I'm a DIY mom and I enjoy painting. And if I am able to do these paintings for my kids, then I'm happy to do so. So this is how I came up, guys. That's it for now, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and don't forget to click that like button and subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye!